Your host is Mr. Ishengoma. We are going to look at area of similar shapes. Now, remember when we talk about area of shapes, it's basically when you are given any shape like this rectangle, I can be given this. So when I'm given this kind of information, I know to get area will be length times width. And when I multiply, I will get 4 times 7, it will give me 28. So if I want to find area, and if I know length and width, basically it will be easy. The problem is, if I am given a shape like this one, and I have one side X, and I have perhaps one side 7. Here, if I have X and 3, here I cannot find area because one side is missing. But using similarity, like here I have 4, here I have 7, I will be able to find X by taking the proportions of 7 over X and 4 over 3. And finally, I get the value of X. And after getting X, I find the area. But take a situation whereby I have got both shapes, rectangles. This side I know, and I know the area, they say 28 centimeters square, and the side is centimeter, but this side, I know only one side, let's say 5, and I need to find area. I will not be able to find area of this side because I don't have two sides. But if this shape here and this shape here, if the two shapes are similar, I will be able to find area of this shape using similarity. Now, let us see how do we find it using similarity. We take the area of the bigger shape over the area of the smaller shape to give us the constant square, because this is now area. Since I'm dealing with areas, our constant will be squared. But remember that always the value of K will never change. It will always be length 1 over length 2. This means if my value of X is, my value of K is L1 over L2, and we know K is the same. Therefore, this formula and the values of K can give me my other formula, and that is area 1 over area 2 is equal to substitute K, keep L1 over L2. Now, if I have this kind of formula of areas in similar shape, I will be in position to continue and solve this one like this. Area 1 over area 2 is equal to L1 over L2 squared. Substitute the values. The area of the bigger shape is 28 over the area of the smaller shape is 8. The length of the bigger shape is 7. The length of the smaller shape is 5 square. My first step, I will open the bracket. 28 over A is equal to 49 over 25, because 7 square is 49, 5 square is 25. then I'll go ahead and cross multiply. 28 times 25 is equal to 49a. So I'll multiply 28 times 25, and it will give me 700 equal to 49a. Over 49, hence my area will be 700 divided by 49, that is 14.3 centimeter square, because that is area. This is how we basically find area. Let's see a second example for more practice. If I have a small trapezium and a bigger trapezium, and perhaps this is 30 meters square, this is 200 meters square, this side, let's say it is X, this side, let's say it is 15. In order for me to find X, because I am given that, I'm given the area of the bigger shape, I'm given the area of the smaller shape. In order to find the length of side, I will use the formula for finding area of similar shapes. A1 over A2 is equal to L1 over L2 squared. That's my formula. I'll go ahead and substitute 200 over 30, that is bigger area over smaller area. Bigger area over smaller area is equal to bigger length over smaller length squared. Then I'll open my brackets. 15 squared is equal to 225 over X squared. 30, I cross multiply. 30 times 200, 30 times 225 will give me 6750 is equal to 200 X squared. Divide by 200, divide by 200. Simplify. X squared is equal to 6750 divided by 200, and that is 33.75. Finally, I square root. I get my length of side will be 5.809, and that will round off to 5.81. So basically, if I am given areas of the two shapes, and if I'm given one length, I can use similarity to find the length of one side. And before, we saw in the first example, if I'm given area of the bigger shape, and I am not given the area of the smaller shape, but I am given both lengths of sides, I will be able to find the other area using similarity. Just to remind you, the main formula for areas of similar shape, that is area 1 over area 2 is equal to K squared. And I prefer you to keep area of the bigger shape up over area of the smaller shape down. That will easily be rememberable for you. But we know K stands for length 1 over length 2. This means length of the bigger shape over length of the smaller shape. And we say, since K and K is the same thing, we can substitute K here. And after substituting K, we get area 1 over area 2 is equal to length 1 over length 2 squared. Remember, area big up, length big up. Area small down, length small down. Hence, using the formula of the combination of the two will basically help me to solve questions as what I have done there. I used it here, and also for example two, I used it there. This is how we solve questions on areas of similar shape. Thank you for watching. My name is Mr. Ishii.